Broadcasting live all over the world at WGHTradio.com. This is North Jersey 1500 WGHT.
WGHT Morning Show with Jimmy Howes and Greta Latona.
The end of the Civil War was near when quite accidentally a hero who sneezed abruptly seized retreat and reversed into victory.
Stand up straight. I know that brings back good memories for you. North Jersey 1500 WGHD, 7:34 in your morning show, and joining us, an American actor known for his comic TV roles, including voiceover work, Mr. Whoopie on Tennesse Tuxedo and his Tales live action role. Of course, you know him as Corporal Randolph Agorn of F Troop. Joining us this morning, Lawrence Samuel, Larry Storch. Good morning to you, sir. Thank you for joining the morning show.
Good morning. It's my pleasure to be with you.
Hey, Corporal Agorn. Hello, Mr. Larry Storch.
How you doing?
Good. We're real excited about you being at Wild West City this Saturday. It's going to be good to see you out there in the dirt with your boots on.
Well, yeah, it'll be. I'm always kick. It's always a kick for me to put the boots on and meet the people. Really.
Hey, Larry, you do a lot of appearances as Corporal Agorn, but you were not only Corporal Agorn. You have a long storied history. You even had the Larry Storch Show in the 50s, but you did a lot of cartoon work. You did a lot of stand-up comic work. You did a lot of things before you were Corporal Agorn. And as a matter of fact, I have a list of TV shows that you were on. Get Smart, Sergeant Bilko, Columbo, Chips, Fantasy Island, McCloud, The Flying Nun, That Girl, The Monkees, I Dream of Jeannie, Gomer Pyle, Gilligan's Island.
Stop, you're killing me.
Larry, you went to high school with Don Adams?
No, we didn't go to high school together. We grew up together and lived on practically the same street together. And we all had our aspirations when we were kids, but we never dreamed that it would turn out the way it did. But
where did you grow up? What street? Do you remember?
Well, I lived in in the Bronx, in Manhattan, in Brooklyn.
Yeah.
So I lived in pretty much all around New York.
Hey, Larry, check this out. Just stay on the phone for a second. We have a snip of you on F Troop. Let's hear it, Gret.
All right, now let's look alive. It's all you have to do all day, so let's do it right. Swenson! If you're awake, let your face know about it.
Larry, you're the best.
I remember those scenes, really.
When you guys filmed F Troop, were you dying from the heat in those heavy uniforms?
It was pretty warm, but we kept drinking enough water. They kept telling us, drink water, drink water. Which we did, so it wasn't too bad, you know.
You've worked on the Sonny and Cher Show, Laugh-In, Hollywood Squares, Ed Sullivan, Johnny Carson, on and on. Could you tell us what it was like to meet Ed Sullivan and be on the Ed Sullivan Show?
Well, you know, he was a kind of a figure who, he didn't socialize much, and I didn't really get to meet Ed Sullivan for any length of time. He just told me what he wanted, and then next.
Yeah.
He didn't spend much time with you.
How about Jackie Gleason? Because Gleason personally asked for you to fill in for him during the summer while Gleason was on hiatus. Did you have a relationship or know Jackie Gleason too well?
No, I didn't. But I remember when he said, hey, Storch, Larry, he said, I'm going to let you take over the show. I'm going to leave Art Carney with you. We're on live, so don't get up when we're on live. So if you're dead, don't get up during the middle of a scene.
That's great. You were also on Car 54. See all this.
Yeah,
besides
I love doing that show too.
You were a laugh riot playing that drunk on Car 54.
I tell you, and I was very lucky. I got to work with Joey Ross.
Yeah.
Hey, hey, Francis. Look, you know, I love Joey Ross, and I love doing that show, Car 54.
Did Joey Ross talk like that in real life? What did he?
Yes, he did. The That was from his nightclub act. When he couldn't remember what was coming next, he used to say, now I remember, you know. But that ooh, ooh was part of a survival technique.
No kidding. What was Forrest Tucker like?
He was, listen, I owe practically my career to this guy. When we auditioned, he told the producer, I think this guy, Larry and I, will be very funny together. And he said, Larry can do the dialects, the Mexican dialect, which was so popular at the time. It's still popular, you know. And so I can do, and because I grew up in New York, my mother had a rooming house with actors and people who came from Europe. If they came from England, if they came from Great Britain, I was able to do all those dialects.
Oh,
you know.
Yes.
So they took advantage of that, and I was very lucky that they did.
Remember when you were Corporal Agarnoff?
Yeah, that was my cousin from Moscow.
What was it like doing Tennesse Tuxedo? You were Professor Phineas J. Whoopie.
Well, you know, I worked with Frank Morgan, the old great actor Frank Morgan, and so I took his voice and I used it for Tennesse Tuxedo.
Phineas J. Whoopie, you're the greatest.
Thank you very much again.
You were on All in the Family with Carol O'Connor.
Right.
And you played his old childhood friend who was a ladies' man.
Right.
And you came and you visited Archie Bunker, and you worked some great scenes with Carol O'Connor in All in the Family.
I was very honored.
Was he actually like Archie Bunker in real life?
In a little bit he was, yeah. In a way he was like Archie Bunker. I used to do him in my act. I try to do Archie Bunker, and I got away with it.
One of the most gifted actors of TV's
sure
greatest
was.
Era. And so are you, Larry Storch.
Oh, come on. Thank you very much.
I'd like to thank you for joining Greta Latona and myself. We're going to be giving away tickets the rest of the week to see you at Wild West City this Saturday. The great Larry Storch, Corporal Agon, Phineas J. Whoopie, and so many other great cartoon characters throughout the years. The great Larry Storch, thank you so much for being on WGHT.
Oh, come on. It's my pleasure. Thank you.
All right. Have a great day, Larry. See you Saturday.
Okay, kiddo. I've been looking forward to it.
The end of the Civil War was near when, quite accidentally, a hero who sneezed abruptly seized retreat and reversed it to victory. His medal of honor pleased and thrilled his proud little family group. While getting it on, some blood was spilled, and so it was planned he'd command F troop. Where Indian fights are colorful sights and nobody takes a licking. When pale face and red skin both turn chicken. When drilling and fighting get them down, they know their morale can't droop. As long as they all relax in town before they resume with a bang and a boom. Half troop!
That's all you have to do all day, so let's do it right! Swenson! If you're awake, let your face know about it!
Larry, you're the best.
I remember those scenes, really.
When you guys filmed F Troop, were you dying from the heat in those heavy uniforms?
It was pretty warm, but we kept drinking enough water. They kept telling us, drink water, which we did. So it wasn't too bad, you know.
You've worked on the Sonny and Cher Show, Laugh-In, Hollywood Squares, Ed Sullivan, Johnny Carson, on and on. Could you tell us what it was like to meet Ed Sullivan and be on the Ed Sullivan Show?
Well, you know, he was a kind of a figure who, he didn't socialize much, and I didn't really get to meet Ed Sullivan for any length of time. He just told me what he wanted, and then next.
Yeah.
he didn't spend much time with you.
How about Jackie Gleason? Because Gleason personally asked for you to fill in for him during the summer while Gleason was on hiatus. Did you have a relationship or know Jackie Gleason too well?
No, I didn't, but I remember when he said, "Hey, Storch, Larry," he said, I'm gonna let you take over the show. I'm going to leave Art Carney with you. We're on live, so don't get up when the... We're on live, so if you're dead, don't get up during the middle of a scene.
That's great. You were also on Car 54. See, all this
I loved doing that show, too.
You were a laugh riot playing that drunk on Car 54. My dad absolutely adored you when you did that part.
Oh, I tell you, and I was very lucky. I got to work with Joey Ross.
Yeah.
Hey, hey, Francis, look who, you know, I loved Joey Ross, and I loved doing that show, Car 54.
Did Joey Ross talk like that in real life? What did he?
Yes, he did. Yes, he did. That was from his nightclub act when he couldn't remember what was coming next. He used to say, now I remember, But that was part of a survival technique.
No kidding. Holy Toledo. What was I going to ask you next, Larry? I forgot. Hey, Larry, what was Forrest Tucker like?
He was, I owe practically my career to this guy. He, when we auditioned, he told the producer, "I think this guy, Larry, and I will be very funny together." And he said, "Larry can do the dialects, the Mexican dialect, which was so popular at the time. It's still popular, you know." And so I can do, and because I grew up in New York, my mother had a rooming house with actors and people who came from Europe. If they came from England, if they came from Great Britain, I was able to do all those dialects.
Oh,
you know.
Yes.
And so they took advantage of that, and I was very lucky that they did.
Remember when you were Corporal Agarnov?
Yeah, that was my cousin from Moscow.
That was great. Hey, Larry, what was it like doing Tennesse Tuxedo? Tennesse Tuxedo. You were Professor Phineas J. Whoopie.
Well, you know, I worked with Frank Morgan, the old great actor Frank Morgan, and so I took his voice and I used it for Tennesse Tuxedo.
Phineas J. Whoopie, you're the greatest.
Thank you very much again.
Larry Storch, what's the secret to being married to the same woman for how many decades?
I was married for... See, let me see. About 40 years or so.
That's unheard of in Hollywood.
I don't know. I don't know any secrets that I can give you for being married that long. But my wife was an aspiring actress, and so we had something in common.
Yeah, that's important, right? It really is. It really is.
Hello?
Hi, I'm still here, Larry. And, one more question for you. Wild West City this Saturday. Did they give you a time yet that you're going to be there? Or you just show up?
This coming Saturday at Lake Hapatcon.
Lake Hapatcon?
No, there's no special time that I'm going to be there. I suppose I'll be there by 10 o'clock.
Shaking hands, meeting people. The great Larry Storch. Larry, I'd like to thank you so much for being on the morning show today.
Oh, come on. It's my pleasure. Thank you.
It's early in the morning, Larry.
That's all right. I've been on my head. I stand on my head every morning.
Hey, one more. Did you meet... You were on the Monkees. Did you meet the Monkees? What was it? It's a
long time ago.
It is, yeah. I can't remember too much about them.
How about I Dream a Genie? Larry Hagman. What was he like? You were on I Dream a Genie.
No, I didn't. I don't remember. I don't remember being in any scenes with Larry Hagman.
How about Jim Nabors? Gomer Pyle?
No, I'm sorry. I can't help you out with those guys either.
Gilligan's Island?
Who? Gilligan's Island. Who else was in Gilligan's Island? I can't remember.
Bob Denver.
Oh, he was a nice enough guy to work with.
And the last one I want to ask you about, and this one is a great part that you played. You were on All in the Family with Carol O'Connor.
Right.
And you played his old childhood friend who was a ladies' man.
Right.
And you came and you visited Archie Bunker, and you worked some great scenes with Carol O'Connor in All in the Family.
I was very honored.
Carol O'Connor, was he actually like Archie Bunker in real life?
In a little bit he was, yeah. In a way he was like Archie Bunker. And I used to do him in my act. I try to do Archie Bunker, and I got away with it.
Yeah, you did. One of the most gifted actors of TV's
sure
greatest
was.
Era. Yeah, and so are you, Larry Storch.
Oh, come on. Thank you very much.
I'd like to thank you for joining Greta Latona and myself. We're going to be giving away tickets the rest of the week to see you at Wild West City this Saturday. The great Larry Storch, Corporal Aegon, Phineas J. Whoopie, and so many other great cartoon characters throughout the years. The great Larry Storch, thank you so much for being on WGHT.
Come on. It's my pleasure. Thank you.
All right. Have a great day, Larry. See you Saturday.
Okay, kiddo. I've been looking forward to it.
The end of the Civil War was near when quite accidentally a hero who sneezed abruptly seized retreat and reversed into victory. His medal of honor pleased and thrilled his proud little family group. While getting it on, some blood was spilled, and so it was planned he'd command F troop. Indian fights are colorful sights, and nobody takes a licking when pale face and red skin both turn chicken. When drilling and fighting get them down, they know their morale can't droop. As long as they all relax in town before they resume with a bang and a boom. F troop.